Now let's go ahead and use jQuery to make our page do something. So I'm going to go to 15.js. When we learned about events, we learned about writing an event listener like this. So you could say window.add event listener DOM content loaded. And then that's going to take a function with one parameter, an event. And then it's going to do something when the DOM is loaded. Something. So the way you do that in jQuery is a little simpler. You just say function event, do something. So these two pieces of code mean roughly the same thing. There's a little tiny difference between this document ready thing and DOM content loaded. This is actually guaranteed to run even if you add a DOM content loaded event, but these are close enough. So this is where all of our code is going to go that does the initialization. And for now, I'm going to go ahead and make use of some global variables, but I'm going to fix that later on. So what do I want to do when the page gets loaded, when the DOM content is loaded? Well, one thing I want to do is I want to attach a resize event handler to the window. And you could do this once again by adding a resize event listener to the window object using straight JavaScript. But here in jQuery land, the syntax is a little more concise. You just get the window, pass in a DOM object as the selector, and you get a jQuery object that wraps that DOM object, dot, and then the jQuery object has a resize method. So instead of having to add an event listener and passing in a function, I just say resize, and then some function that gets called when the window is resized. So I'm going to go ahead and just create a function called resize and pass that in. So here's my function resize. And this is going to get an event. But I'm not actually going to do anything with the event here, so I'm just going to go ahead and do that. So what I want to do is when the window is resized, I want to get the width and the height of the window. And in straight DOM, you would get the window object, and then you get the style info for that, and then you get the width and height from the style info. Here in jQuery, you get the window object, and you call height, like so. So let's go ahead and console.log new dimensions. And we're going to get the window height and window width. And actually, I should have put width first because it's usually X followed by Y. There. So let's go ahead and see if this works. I'm going to save that and go back and reload. And then if I move that, you see the dimensions of the window are changing. So what do I want to do when the window is resized? Well, let's start with this tile class. So in my CSS, I'm going to add some styling for tile. And let's go ahead and add a border to it. 1 pixel solid black. And let's display this as an inline block. And I'm going to add a margin to it as well, because I want some space between my tiles. So let's say 2 pixels there. And for now, let's give it a little background color. Let's just make it gray, make it light gray. And I'll center the text. And I'm also going to be positioning this absolute relative to the board, but I'll come back to that. So let's go ahead and do that. So there are my tiles. And then what I want to do is I want to resize each tile so that it takes up about a quarter of the width and about a quarter of the height, including the margin and padding. So let's go ahead and inspect this. And if I make this be, let's go ahead and set the width to 10 pixels and the height to 10 pixels. So if I make that 10 by 10 and reload, and then select that and inspect it. So you see the actual content is 10 pixels, plus 1 for the border, plus 2 for the margin, giving the final dimensions, it says 12 by 12, but it's actually 13 by 13, I think. So I can actually change that as well. So let's go ahead and get all of the tile elements. And then let's take the first one and look at the width and the height. And then I'm going to set the width to be 30. And I'm going to set the height to be 30. So first I'm going to go ahead and figure out the width of the window. Then I'm going to subtract off the margin. So let's go ahead and look at the margin. So window dot, and margin is a CSS property, so I have to go CSS to get my CSS properties. And then the property I want is margin. Let me try the body here. Okay, so the body margin is 8 pixels, so the window goes full width, and then the body is 8 pixels in from there. So the actual width that I want to fill is window.width minus 2 times this body margin, which is going to be 8 pixels, so 2 times 8. So how do I go from having 8px to the number 8? Well, I'm going to use parseInt for that. So that will basically just ignore the px and return me the number 8. So window.width minus 2 times parseInt $body.css margin. So that gives me how much space I want to fill. So let's go ahead and add that in my JavaScript. Var window width is that. And then the window height is also going to be basically the same thing, except I'm going to grab the height and subtract the margin off from there. So then let's go ahead and get rid of that. So now what I want to do is I want to divide this by 4 to get my tile width and tile height. And I'm going to make those global to this function. Later on, I'm going to put everything in a closure so they'll be local to the closure. But for now, I'm going to have a tile width and a tile height. And I guess I'll make these a little easier to read. So tile width is window width over 4. And tile height is window height over 4. And then let's go ahead and console.log tile width and tile height and reload and resize. So this is about 222 pixels, about a quarter of the screen, and about 77 down. So you'll notice this is the bottom of the window right here. So now what I want to do is I want to set the width and height of all of these tiles. And once again, jQuery makes that pretty easy. So $tile.width tile width dot height tile height. So this gets all of my tiles, and then this sets the width of all the tiles, and it also returns all of the tiles. So I can chain these two things together. So this is called chaining. I take it and then I apply that and I apply that, and you can put together fairly complicated pipes fairly concisely like that. So let's go ahead and see what happens. And then when I resize, it pops up and resizes it. So let's go ahead and also make sure that we call resize once when the window is finished loading. Great. Now another thing I want to do is I want to scale this number so that it fits in the box. So I'm going to go ahead and set font size equal to the math.min of tile width and tile height. So I want it to fit either the narrowest box or the shortest box. And then let me move this up here. And I'm going to add, so this is a CSS property I'm going to change. And I want to set the text size property to font size plus pixels. And jQuery doesn't make you do this, so I can just say font size here, I think. In DOM, I would have to specify pixels, but jQuery will just work. Oh, maybe I'm wrong. So let's go ahead and plus pixels. Let me see what I'm getting here. So font size is 77.5. Let's go ahead and $tile dot CSS font size. That returns the value. And then this sets the value. Does that work? That doesn't work. That does work. So let's take a look at what I'm setting here. Oh, font size. Okay. Font size. There we go. There we go. So that works. Now this is a little big because these characters have descenders as well. If you actually look at the box for that text. So let me go ahead and put a span in there so you can see what I mean. So I'll put a span and then reload. and then inspect. So you'll see, even though I set the size to 77.5 pixels, the actual span is really 86 pixels because of that descender. So what I really want to do here is make it a little smaller than the box. And I found that 0.8 times that actually works pretty well. So 0.8 times font size plus the text pixels. So that's relatively good. So let's go ahead and squish it down. Not perfect, but good enough.